Hello everybody, this is Carla from What If. Today I'm actually going to do my first YouTube video, so you know, please bear with me. I'm actually going to show you how I put a base coat on a cup. A lot of people have asked me how I do my cups. I do a lot of different techniques for the base coats, and in this scenario I'm going to actually show you how I use colored epoxy and glitter to make a cup. So I've got a couple kinds of glitter. I actually have an alumilite dye that I can put in my epoxy, as you can see. And I have soap dye, little mica dye, I guess if you want to call it that, that also can be put in epoxy to provide a color. So I'm going to use these three items to put a coat on a cup. So I happen to like these straight up tumblers. They're a 20 ounce tumbler. I like the fact that it's a straight line. That way when I put a design on it, it doesn't have a warp based on the cup getting bigger at the top and smaller at the bottom. These are stainless steel. They come in different colors. I don't really even pay attention to the color because I'm gonna cover the entire cup, so it doesn't really matter to me. But they will hold something hot for up to 6 hours and cold for 24, I think is what they say. So I really like them, and everybody that I've given them to seems to really enjoy them as well. I use a turning machine, and this is the little spindle that goes on it. It's from a gentleman that you can buy off of Etsy. His Etsy shop is Absolute Programming. I think he's out of Texas. I'll put a link in the YouTube video at the bottom, so in case you're interested in his turners, they're fabulous. I actually have three. This is a single up turner. I have a double up, which has spots for two cups, and I have a quad turner, so I have the ability to put four cups on at one time, which is super nice. I use a two-part epoxy. Whoops. Part A and Part B. This is from a company called Alumilite. I buy direct from them. You can also buy them, I think, at Michael's, Hobby Lobby, those type of stores in smaller quantities. The one thing about doing tumblers is the tumbler has to spin for a long time. Otherwise, your epoxy is going to slide off the tumbler, or you'll end up with a large thick part at the bottom and it's not smoothly adhered to the cup. So by buying one of these turners, you alleviate that issue. And I'm gonna turn it on right now. His turners, the thing I like about them is they're hard to turn on, but they're very quiet. So I originally made my own turner from a rotisserie that I got at Lowe's. And at the end of the day, I think I spent just as much on all the pieces and parts of making a turner than buying it directly from him. And the part that's really nice is all of his turners are magnetic. So this little part here has a magnet in it. So when you place it on there, it holds and turns very nicely. Really, really love his turners. So I'm going to start by mixing my two epoxies together. So I'll probably speed up through this section a little bit, but I'm going to mix those two together until they basically become clear again. They get kind of murky looking, and you have to mix them slowly and thoroughly. Otherwise, you'll end up with bubbles as well. But because I'm using the Alumilite dyes, it takes a lot of the bubbles out of the final finish. I wish they had a clear that I could put into the epoxy, because then my life would be fabulous. Because bubbles, when you're first starting out, seem to be the hardest part. I've been making cups now for a little over a year. This is just kind of started off as my hobby, little project hobby. I like to try new things. And I just have kept going and going because I really love the creativity that I can get by making cups or tumblers. I've tried lots of different techniques. I've done hydro dipping, and I think everybody that I've seen on Facebook and some of the other lives tend to do a lot of glitter cups. I tend to try something completely different. I do a lot of painting on cups. I've done some modeling paste through stencils. I have friends that are mixed media artists, and they give me quite a bit of creative ideas and things, techniques I can use on my cups. In fact, I just recently tried, I'll show you, I just recently tried making a cup using jelly printed paper that you tear into pieces and apply on the cup and build up to make a scene. So I've made a couple little owls, and I've applied it to a cup. It doesn't look too great right now, but when I put some epoxy on it, that cup is gonna look fabulous. That's the one thing I've noticed about doing these tumblers is paint or anything that you put on it, it looks so much different once you get the epoxy on top. So I'm actually gonna split these two pieces of epoxy about half and half into two cups, mainly because I'm gonna do one in white and one in a teal color, just to kind of do a swirl pattern on the cup. And so this is the white dye. I'm gonna put a couple drops in. It doesn't take a whole lot of the dye to completely become that color. So there's my white, and you can kind of see it's just a real, you know, thick paint consistency. And then I'm going to take a little bit of this mica powder and put in the other the little mica powder. I got this off of Amazon. It, like I said, I think it was listed as mica powder for epoxy, soaps, other items that people use. The thing I like about this mica powder is it's got kind of a pearlescence, and I just put a little scoop in there. Not very scientific. And it gives kind of a little pearlescence, a little sheen. You can kind of see it a little bit. It's going to be kind of hard to see until I get it on the cup. But it's very, very much pearlescence in style. And this, since I used a powder, mica powder, it'll have a little few more bubbles in it than my white will. But I'm going to set it aside for a little while, because if after I've mixed it, if I set it aside for a little while, the bubbles will work their way out. And then if they don't, I can always apply a little heat to get the bubbles out of my surface. So I use the finger gloved technique. I know other people use brushes and stuff. I find this works well for me. I'm gonna put a coat of the white down and spread it on my cup. And it doesn't matter that I'm being super precise, because it's kind of leveling, self-leveling. It will work its way around the cup. And I just do it in stripes, because that's what I find works best for me. I go back and forth, just making sure I don't end up with a lot of drips on my wax paper that I have down below here, because this is very sticky, and it does set up hard, and you can usually get it off of like sometimes I do it on a granite countertop, and I can take a knife and peel it off my granite countertop with no problem. This epoxy by Alumilite is a food grade epoxy, so it is safe for drinking out of the cup if any would happen to get, you know, in a food area. And I know that the epoxy says that you're not supposed to put it in the dishwasher. And to be honest with you, most of these cups say that they're not supposed to go in the dishwasher at all either. I think it breaks the seal on them. But I do know of a few people that do put theirs in the top part of their dishwasher and they've had no issues with it. But I don't. I hand wash mine. Just because I put a lot of work in it, so I don't really want to see it destroyed. So I'm not too worried that if I was just making this all white, I probably would have just spray painted it. But I'm actually going to be applying lots of layers on this to give it some depth. The layers with the aqua dye will kind of fill in some of these areas. And then I'm going to have glitter on top as well. And it will, because I'm doing multiple layers, it will actually start to move around on the cup. And it will kind of fill in where you're kind of seeing some of the gray show through right now. You won't, at the end, see the gray. All right, so let's use some of this colored epoxy. And I'm just gonna scoop it up and in no uncertain pattern, just start applying it. It's just the technique that I use. These swirls will start to move around and morph into other patterns. So it really doesn't, I don't have to be very concerned about how I'm applying it. I've tried different techniques. I've done, you know, where I've done vertical stripes and I have done horizontal stripes as well. That's kind of fun as well. All right, so I've applied my first coat of with the colored epoxies. I'm now gonna start applying some of the glitter. And I know a lot of people use a lot of different techniques. I'm a little bit more random in the way I do it. I actually, well, it's not really random. I like to do diagonals and diagonal stripes. Even though the colors are on here below, I will come in and put my epoxy kind of on a diagonal, and it's going to like move around a little bit, even though some of it's falling off, a lot of it's sticking, and then like I said, it's going to move around on the cup as well, and I kind of like that effect. Gives a little bit of a sparkle. And I'm going to take some of the chunkier and put it on there as well, so that we get a really good aqua effect. Whoop. It's really pretty. The one thing about putting chunky glitter on these cups is I end up having to go over and put another clear coat on top, just to kind of seal everything in. This cup, I've actually am going to put a saying on it and a cow because it was a request to have a cow on the cup with a little saying, and that's what I'm going to do on it. So I hope you liked seeing the background. I will create a second video where I show the next phases of this cup, and then you can see the final product as well. So part of what I'm showing you here in this little video clip is how to apply heat to make the glitter move more on the cup. So by applying heat to this, you'll see that the glitter and the colors of the epoxy below will start to move around in different ways. The heat actually makes the epoxy a little thinner and it will start to run. So applying too much heat will actually have the effect of the epoxy running off the cup. So you have to be very cautious when you do apply heat. The other technique that you can use with the heat gun is if you did have some areas where maybe there was an air bubble, the heat would actually take those air bubbles out. I hope you've enjoyed my video. Please like on YouTube and share. I'd appreciate it. Thanks again. This is Carla from What If NC.